Man, original Saeed's makes the best falafel in the world. And much better than the original Saeed.
Well, a lot of it's marketing.
Well, we better enjoy these now, because if there's a transit strike, how are we going to get up to Saeed's and back on lunch hour?
Well, if we left 5 minutes early and then walked really, really, really fast, and then, quit our jobs, I think we can do it.
There's not going to be any transit strike. This is all just a bunch of saber rattling. Trust me. I did my 12th grade paper on collective bargaining. You know, I got the economics medal in school, tops in my class.
And since you were homeschooled by your two moms, the class consisted of you.
No.
Which does not detract from the achievement. The medal was presented to me at a formal assembly by the faculty, who both cried and then let me stay up late and watch Dukes of Hazzard. Well, what do you know? They are going to have a transit strike. What does the union want now? Oh, health benefits.
Well, that's reasonable.
Oh, yeah, sure. Go ahead, Owen. Because what could possibly be on a subway floor? No, no.
Well,
no. Please don't. Please don't. Please don't. I can't. Thank you.
That was quite a gala last night.
You eliminate hunger now, people always put out a great spread. But my favorite part is being with the prettiest girl there.
Oh, you are correct.
Hey, Jeb.
Hey, guy.
Oh, I would have brought you a coffee, but when you carry three, you look like an intern.
Well, no problem, but if you got any green tea on your coffee cart, I'll take one, or maybe a boysenberry scone.
No, 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 this is Kipp. He's an assistant. He works here. Kipp comes from serious money, and in a matter of minutes, he can reduce anybody to tears. He's my best friend.
Oh, so you think I should hire him as my new assistant?
No, I was just letting you know he's not the coffee guy.
He's up. He's got the job.
I will have to tell the Eastern European correspondents that I'm leaving.
Didn't they close that bureau?
Done. I'd love the job.
Welcome to the world of on-air talent. Of course, you'll never be on air, but you can watch me. Now, what do they call you, son?
My name is Kipp.
Well, there's a name you don't forget.
Carl, thank you for giving us a ride to work. We never would have gotten a cab during the strike. Or at 4:30 in the morning, for that matter.
Well, I'm sorry it had to be so early. If I open the cafeteria 1 minute after six, it's pretty much hand-to-hand combat for the donuts.
Wouldn't you just love to hang off the back of that garbage truck just one day?
Yeah, but if they let one guy do it, they gotta let everybody do it. Boy, you sure do see a different side of the city this early, huh?
I've always thought of morning as a time to contemplate the upcoming day and just shut up.
Yeah, philosophy's fun. Oh, I'm sure I've had some good times in Live the Riv. Live is what I call the Riviera, after Swedish film star Liv Ullmann and her sturdy Nordic beauty.
Mm. I like Latin women.
I think it's sweet that you have a name for your car. I have a name for my humidifier.
Broken.
Good one.
Thanks. Damn, I should have hitchhiked.
Hey. So, what'd you get?
Club sandwich.
Roast chicken.
Corn chowder. Cursed original Saeed's. Before we tasted their delicious falafel, this cafeteria food would have been plenty good for us. And now I'm just staring at a big bowl of what could have been.
I hear you.
We've got to figure out a way to get up there during the strike.
Why don't you just ask Carl to borrow his car? And just don't tell him where we're going.
Yeah, if he knew we were eating out, it would crush him.
Yeah, what's worse is we'd be using his car to ditch his food. I mean, come on, that is incredibly sneaky.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
Hey, my favorite customers.
Very proud of that corn chowder.
As well you should be.
In fact, I wish I could stay here and enjoy it longer, but I have an appointment.
Oh, yeah, where do you have to go?
To the dentist. Got a bad tooth.
Really? You've been awfully stoic.
Don't worry, Owen. Dr. Saeed will take care of it.
Oh, yeah, sure. Dr. Saeed. See, he was a lawyer in his country, but here he's a dentist.
Yeah, America rocks. I just don't know how I'm gonna get there. You know, it's gonna be so difficult, what with the transit strike.
Oh, honey, you are faced with a challenge.
I'll give you a ride to your dentist appointment.
No!
No.
No. Because it's lunch hour and you are needed here because you're the man.
That's a good point. Why don't you take the Riv?
Oh, no.
Oh, now, come on. Seriously, I want you to take...
Okay.
Great. Oh, but listen, if you're flooring it and you can't get it over 40, stop flooring it because it's not going over 40.
That's right. We have to talk. I've been obsessing over this all morning. I don't think that I like my best friend working for my boyfriend.
What's the problem?
Well, I'm afraid that you're going to start blabbing about all the stuff that you and I talk about, you know, embarrassing stuff.
Oh, like the time we were making fun of Claude and you laughed so hard you walked into a door. or like when your water bra burst and you told everybody you were lactating. Or like the time that you got so bloated on that minestrone soup that you were begging everybody to take you to the hospital.
Stuff like that. Stuff that a boyfriend doesn't need to know. Okay? Oh, and of course you won't tell him how many men that I've slept with, because I was drunk when I told you that, and I might have exaggerated. On the low side.
Look at him. All sweet and happy, just waiting for his keys. How are we going to tell him we destroyed his car?
We? You were driving.
You saw what happened. I swerved to avoid that pigeon, and then I slammed right into the fire hydrant. I tried to unswerve.
You did the right thing, Claude. That pigeon was adorable. If I had any feeling in my arms, I'd hug you.
Look, I'm the one who smashed up his car, so I should really face him alone. Now, I know that you guys are going to want to stay and support me, but I just think it'd be best if I just... Hey, Carl.
Hey.
Hey. I have some bad news.
Gingivitis?
Oh, no, the teeth are fine. It's about Liv.
Okay, what about Liv?
Well, I messed up somehow, and I am very, very sorry, but I kind of wrecked your car.
You wrecked Liv? That can't be. I just drove her this morning.
Oh, honey, she's totaled.
Peacefully?
Well, after I slammed into the fire hydrant, the engine did kind of ride the geyser up into the street, so... Yeah, I guess you could say kind of peaceful. Carl, I'm so, so sorry, and I want you to know I will pay for the car.
You can't put a price on Liv.
The Kelly Blue Book people tried, but 425 is not gonna bring her back.
There's gotta be something I can do, some way I can make this up to you.
Well, the only thing I can think of is you could maybe sleep with me. You know, comfort sex.
Perhaps something else.
Yeah, I hear ya.
Hey, why don't we all come over tonight and have kind of a impromptu memorial for Liv, you know? That way you could get some closure.
Or I could go get drunk by myself.
You could still do that after we leave.
That'd be real nice. Please, Claude, that's enough. You've done so much already.
Recycling.
The cans or the underwear?
Knock, knock.
Hey,
is this the Minari car funeral?
Cars don't have last names. You know why? They're not people. And they don't have funerals either. They go to the junkyard or they get donated to Boy Scouts. Eulogy over.
I know you think this is weird, but can we just indulge Carl for one moment?
Well, since we're indulging people, where's my gin and tonic?
All he's got is beer and plenty of it.
All right. This was on me.
Sorry for your loss, man. How you holding up?
Oh, Claude's been a godsend. She did everything. She cleaned the place up, she arranged the memorial, she wrecked the car.
And, I made lasagna, too.
Oh, boy, we haven't had Claude's lasagna since my fish died.
Yeah. Well, look, I haven't been to very many of these, but maybe this would be an appropriate time to tell some stories that would really illuminate how special Liv really was.
Well, I guess I could go.
Yeah.
I was thinking you should go first.
Remember one time we piled 8 guys in and drove her straight up to Canada.
What a good car.
You know what really gives me tranquility? Aside from the medication that I took? What was I talking about?
Yeah.
Knowing that she went out the way she spent her life, helping others, helping a friend who had a sore tooth.
Yeah. Well, sore tooth. No matter how the car was helping, it's really not important to dwell on that. Let's move on now.
I was ready to move on 30 seconds after we hit that fire hydrant.
Wait, what do you mean we? I thought it was just Claude.
Yeah, I thought it was just Claude. You know, I gotta get out of here before I admit that I was there, too.
I don't understand.
Okay, look, Carl, we did a bad thing. Okay, I didn't have a dentist appointment. I really should get one, because it's been 6 months and I got this thing. Anyway, I drove us up to Original Saeed's for falafel.
Not in a million years did I think you'd be capable of something so horrible. I'd like you to leave.
Just me? I mean, what about them?
Yeah, why not us?
You're both forgiven.
Dang. Well, this really isn't fair.
You know what else isn't fair? How good this is.
To die for. Oh, I'm sorry, Carl.
So, did you guys talk about me at the wake after I left?
Not really. We weren't allowed to utter your name.
Besides that, it was all right.
Your lasagna was a hit.
Oh, and we broke the dish.
Why is Carl mad at me and not at you guys?
Because you're the good one, Claude. Everyone expects more from you. It's the same reason the Lord was so mad at Lucifer when he fell. He was the brightest angel in the sky.
Oh, thanks, Ramona. Now you're calling me the devil?
No, I'm likening you to the devil.
Don't be so sensitive.
You haven't said anything about me to Jeb, have you?
No.
Attaboy. Although, I've given it some thought, and I've decided that there are some topics that are safe for you to discuss.
Oh, I see you've been hard at work this morning. Okay, what are the safe topics?
Any general discussion about how amazing I am is allowable. Also, it's okay with me if you bring up all the romantic things that he could do for me.
Well, Lydia, I don't want to do that.
Hey, I accidentally got you this job.
Okay, but I do this for you and we're even. For life.
Good. Things like sending me English tea roses every month on the anniversary of the day that we met.
Okay, what day did you meet?
I don't know. Do I have to do your job for you? Hi, Jeff. Loved your segment.
Wow, we'll discuss the highlights later.
Okay.
Is my conference call set up for tomorrow morning?
You bet your earpiece it is. Hey, you know what I was thinking? I was thinking that it might be nice to do something romantic for Lydia. I mean, you know, she and I have known each other for a long time, and I do know that she loves English tea roses.
Oh, so you're suggesting I send roses to Lydia?
Yeah. Isn't that a great idea?
You're fired.
What? It was a suggestion. I don't even like it.
When an assistant begins meddling in my personal life, it's time to send them packing. Be gone.
This is my dad.
Oh, now there's back talk. Why don't you get up, take a walk around this floor, don't come back until I'm gone.
Here you go, Madeline. I know you like your sweets.
It's chilly, Carl.
I'm sorry. I'm dealing with a loss.
Carl, can I talk to you for a second, please?
Make it quick. I'm busy.
Look, I am truly, truly, truly sorry about your car, and I really want to be your friend, but I think that you're being way too hard on me.
Well, you should have known better.
That's the problem, you know? Everybody always thinks I should have known better. Well, sometimes I just don't, you know? I'm not perfect. I do bad things.
Come on.
Oh, I do. Okay. I lied to my mother about how I spent the savings bond that she gave me for high school graduation. Yeah, colored contacts. And then sometimes when someone's running for the elevator, I don't always press, like, the door open button. I just pretend to, like, oh, sorry. And once I gave Canadian quarters to a blind man.
No.
Yes, I did. It's true. Now, granted, I was in Toronto, but that's not the point, okay? The point is, if you want us to be friends, you're gonna have to realize that I can be just as bad as everybody else.
I like the bad, Claude.
Good.
Yeah, you're hot. Bad, Claude. You're the bad girl.
Hey, buddy, where you been all morning?
I had my spin class.
Well, I needed you. I had a conference call, couldn't figure out the hoojinging.
Okay, you fired me.
Fired you? You're gonna have to have thicker skin than that if you're gonna work with me. I just told you to take a walk.
So I'm still your assistant?
Secretary. I'd like to bring that word back.
Well, I gotta be honest with you, I don't want to be called secretary.
Well, you keep talking about roses and romance and what I should get my girlfriend. I mean, what are you expecting to call you?
An assistant.
Somebody needs a back talk walk.